Good morning and Jai Hind. In this video, we are going to discuss a numerical of common size balance sheet. So let us read the question. In this question, we are asked to prepare a common size balance sheet, and a balance sheet of KG Limited is also given here, where shareholder funds, non-current liabilities, current liabilities were given here for the year 2017 and 16. And similarly, few assets are also given in the question, like non-current assets and current assets for both the years are given. So we are asked to prepare a common size balance sheet of KJ Limited. So let's start. On the top, we have to write the common size balance sheet as at date 31st March 2017, because here 2016 is the previous year and 2017 is the current year. So we have to follow the same format here of the balance sheet. In the first column, we have to write the particulars. All the liabilities and equities are above, and below that we have to write the assets. Next column is for the note number, and after that there would be four columns. In the first two, there would be an absolute change for both the years separately, and in the next two columns there would be a percentage of the total of again both the years for the previous and the current year. So let us start the question now. First, we have to write in particular column all the equities and liabilities which are given in a question. As you can see, first there would be a shareholder funds, then non-current liabilities, then current liabilities, and below that there would be an asset of non-current assets and current assets. Okay, just we have to follow the question here. For the first absolute amount, we have to just write the amounts which are given in a question, and please be active that we need to place the previous year before the current year details. Okay, first we have to write the previous year, then afterwards in the next column we can write the current year details. So as you can see, all the details are given here for the year 2016 and 17 in case of absolute change. It was written as it is, as in which is given in our question. And after that, in the next two columns, percentage of the total for the year 2016 could be calculated in case of shareholder funds by dividing the 4 lakhs by the total amount, that is 8 lakhs in 200. That means for this we have to write the absolute amount upon total of the balance sheet into 100 for each of the details given in a balance sheet. For the case of year 2017, here also you can see the shareholder funds is given as 8 lakhs and the total is 16 lakhs. So we can divide 8 lakhs by 16 lakhs into 100. It gives 50%. Similarly, in case of non-current liabilities also, you can see that 2 lakhs is the amount of non-current liabilities for the year 2016. So we have to divide 2 lakhs by 8 lakhs, which gives into 100, which gives 25% as the answer. Similarly, for the year 2017 also, we can calculate by non-current liabilities by dividing 5 lakhs by 16 lakhs in 200. It gives 31.25 lakhs. So in this way, we have to calculate all the percentage of the total of each of the items separately of each of the year. And by calculating this, we got the value of current liability for the year 2016 as 25% and for 2017 as 18.75%. In case of total also, we have to calculate the percentage by dividing 8 lakhs by 8 lakhs in 200. It gives 100%. Similarly, for the year 2017 also, we have to divide 16 lakhs by 16 lakhs in 200. okay, again it gives 100%. So in this way we will calculate all the percentage of the total of each of the item separately for the both of the years, previous year and for the current year.